What is good? Back again with your old mate Mott. Like, comment, subscribe, do all of those good things, and enjoy the video.
I mean, it's called episodes, so that's what we're going with. I'm just getting the old OBS up and running, and then we'll kick it off. Chapter 3. Let's go.
Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
Episode 3.
How did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you you were too hard on her.
Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the
All right, Randolph.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trail. That Rose, she's a nice girl.
Always yeah, limpy boy.
On time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zink. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer. But I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote.
I thought I could hear an echo.
He was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
There are a lot of propane tanks here. I'm just looking around for coffee and manuscripts, don't you worry. It's a perfectly normal thing to do in a strange place.
Come on, mister. I'll take you to Rose's trail.
Russell, it's just you, Randy. You're a goddamn ghost. You're old lady, aren't you? What was the clicking? Why is there so much fuel here?
Just follow me. It's not far. Listen, I got things to do. This place don't run itself.
I'm sure it doesn't.
Oh, give me
coffee.
A break, mister. Can we just get a move on?
Well, keep up with
yeah,
me, dude.
How about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers.
The boat? Gotta move around the boat. Barry, on my six, buddy. We found a coffee, but no pages. Someone chopping wood out there? That doesn't bode well. Considering most of the enemies I've killed so far have been from the lumberyard. Randy's dogs. Come on down to Randy Dogs. Hot dog, chili dog, corn dog, taco dog. Alright, take me to Rose. Come on, hop along.
It gets better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The Scratching Hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless anymore.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Nothing out here. I just want these pages. My wife's in danger. She's also a robot. Do you know how much wire that is? Do you know how much wire costs? Freaking yokels. I'm a big city author slash roboticist.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk, murder. To her, pal.
Oh, yeah, talk. Nothing to do with murder, don't worry. Rose has got coffee. Was she just sitting there waiting?
Welcome to... Oh, dear. Mr. Wake, I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh, yes. Yes. Please, come in.
You're off your tits, lady.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry... She doesn't have anything.
Yeah, hey, Al? Al, what's... Oh...
Barry! What?
Come on, Ryder Man. You're not my robot wife.
It's coming for you. Hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on.
All right, then. Concussion did a real doozy on you, bud.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me. She's an old woman in a funeral dress. I call her Barbara Jagger. She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right. She promises me I can save Alice this way. She knows more of this than I do, about the complex incantation I'm attempting, about this place. She's worked with another writer under similar circumstances, Thomas Zane. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I'm getting close. I can feel it.
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark.
First refill is free. Milk and sugar on the counter there. Would you like to hear today's specials? Thank
you. Go ahead. Give me the specials.
Have a nice day. Come back soon.
Alright, Rose is catatonic.
Barry was out of it. He was way too ahead of Barry.
You're right. I deserve more money. I'm so handsome.
Barry's a goddamn thief. Corn. Cooking with corn.
My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
Dan, dicka, dan, dicka, dan, dicka, dan, dicka, dan. Nothing in the bins. All right. Someone's having a party. A no light party, is it?
I just stepped outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here talking to you and not home in bed. Once the weather takes a turn like this, I can't sleep at all. It's all tangled bed sheets and dark thoughts, punctuated by the occasional plunge into nightmare. Is it just me?
Baby's crying. Oh, put your hands up, bud.
Oh, you're gonna get it now. God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI! Get him up, Hemingway! You're under arrest! You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face! Stay right where you are, Blaine!
You're really not good at negotiations there, champ. I'm the one! I am the Matrix.
What are... I'm standing right here, you goddamn maniac!
Really, really bad at negotiations.
Behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
So now nothing's gonna attack me in the dark, just the cops.
Thank you.
It is pretty clear that I am a serial killer at this point.
We have the suspect in sight.
Okay, men. Keep your eyes peeled. He's gonna try to make it through here.
Oh, damn.
Oh, damn. Keep running there, buddy. Oh, get up, you. Is that a page I see?
Come on, guys. We need to head him off.
Matrix. Bad things.
Search the area.
That's not how you use flares out here. They're for murdering shadows. And or innocent campers.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Finally, he admits. Come to me, my shadow birds. That's it, monster boy. Catch your breath. Let's go. Where am I supposed to be looking? Yeah, there's a frickin' crashed helicopter. We already knew that.
Jane, Mulligan here. Over.
Wheeler and Rose here. Wheeler's drunk or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that Fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of eau de scotch about him, if you know what I mean. Over. I don't have anything on that, Deputy Mulligan. Over. Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just being plain weird here. You better get Doc in to take a look at both. Over. Gotcha. You better
I could see the lights at the radio station in the distance.
Well, that made me sick.
Hi.
Hi there.
I imagined that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
Why are we going to the coal mine? Oh, I don't know.
Ooh. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't
get Ghost Gate.
You are playing on or Xbox?
PlayStation. Coffee.
There was no power to the searchlight.
Four or five?
Five. You can tell by the quick times. Champ, that's how you fix things. Kick it, start it, let's go. Maybe just way down the freaking tank. This still got electricity going through it. Wait a minute, what's over here? Nothing. Or is. Yeah, it's nothing. It's just around the back of the shed. Batteries. Okay.
It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Do you want to
Reach radio station. All right. Nope. What's going on up here? Nothing. Nothing good. Hey guys. Oh shiznit, that's a big ass cliff. Pressed R1 the first time I got hit. It wasn't enough. Well, there's a page. Nope. Pick that up. Dodge around that. Dodge around that. I said dodge around that, god damn it. You motherfucker. Dirty, great, big galoot. Alright. Back off to the radio station. Come on now. Surprised this dude doesn't have tinnitus yet. He's throwing like 12 flashbangs right next to his own face. Gate. Use the gate.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Big old lights. Nothing else. Alright. Come on. Over. Fine. Go up the goddamn steps. You got any copies of my manuscript in here, bud?
Yeah.
I'm glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him. What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
Down another hill. This trigger happy fuck not.
I'll get you yet, even if it kills me. You hear me? You hear me, H.P. Lovecraft?
I hope it does kill you.
So many cliffs, it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
Train depot. I still don't know why we're going to the mine. You fucking people. You don't want none when I'm in the freaking light, do you? Straight to the checkpoint. Let's go.
There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Come on through. The darkness controls the ticket. Well, I already figured that. Whoa, shit! He was closer than I thought. Little shits. In light, you can hurt them. Alright, cool. The light doesn't seem to last very long, does it? What else are we looking for? Manuscript pages and coffee. I think that's all I'm gonna find here. Alright. Off to the train station in a quick hurry.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice? I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me.
Let's go to the secret box. Definitely not a trap. Max ammo. Ah, god damn it. What happened to my flashbangs? Back it up, you shadow folks. Peace out. I'm running. Fuck off.
I see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Everyone knows shadows can't climb ladders, but neither can I. God damn it. All the way back up here. I've fallen off like 70 freaking cliffs.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Yes, yes, we've already heard it.
Alice?
What happened to all of my... Yeah, we know. Come on, champ. Just... You married a murderer, Mrs. Robot.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me.
She actually called me. She really cares. Any coffee? Nope. All right. Then I open this, and then the bad guys come. Nope. 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 I said no, you little weirdo. Your asses up.
I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Follow. Just as I thought, shadows can't climb ladders. You sucker punks.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
It's a very poorly maintained bridge. Alright, you frickin' maniac. Jesus. God damn it. Did I at least hit a checkpoint here? Fuck! Beaten up by the goddamn bridge. Wait, I didn't want the flare. What happened to my flashbangs? They were so much better. Alright, that cliff, you can't fall down. I already ruined it. I picked up a flare earlier, apparently.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alice?
You wall from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me.
Come on, mate, you need better cardio. I see you, creepies. I run like such an old man.
I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore.
Come on, I'll find a car from there. 100% dodge that. Not again! For the love of all things good, this has to stop. I'm just trying not to kill any more people. Yes, I know.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Yeah, the most stubborn Alice? Man I've ever met. Alice? When I look behind your eyes, I see someone else. Rowdy, rowdy, row. I'm playing lightsabers. Leave me alone.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me.
Now it looks like we're just gonna have to do more murders. You got a scythe, do ya? I've got a goddamn shotgun. Oh, looks like the scythe and hatchets work just fine for these folk. Come on then, big buddy. What you got?
I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.
It's not a warehouse, it's a water tower.
Over everything in its path.
you wouldn't mind getting the fuck out of the way. Fucking nuisance, man. Where's the goddamn gate?
As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Coffee, 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 coffee. Whew, that was close. You pieces of shit. I think there was a jump puzzle out here. At least a flare. Nope. Probably not. Emptying rounds into these mother truck nuts. What else is an insane man about to do? In light, you can hurt them. I already know that. Thank you. Man, this is about to be the longest episode I've done to date. Radio can't be turned on. Turn on radio. TV.
We take the facts of our existence for granted, unaware that they are merely a thin veneer of desperate self-delusion, covering a vast cosmos of madness and horror. All too often, the stars are right. Thank you.
dun, dun. Shit. God damn it. I swear, if it puts me all the way back, I'm going to lose my shit. Flares. Piece of shit. Fuck off, you cunts! Fucking bullshit. Actually move the camera. What do you got for me? Batteries and bullets, eh?
fuck. Just double teamed by a pair of fucking lumber dicks. Fucking douchebags. What are ya? A fucking douche. Somewhat over elaborate gates right there. You only need one to move. That's too many moving parts. Doesn't need to be that much. We've got a car. I'm guessing we're missing a note from this area, but I don't care. Grand Theft Auto added to the list of crimes.
I had never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. Coal mine wasn't far now.
We'll get there already, would you? I'm sick of this. Why are you doing all this shit at night? Oh, for
today,
the love of...
I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
Well, that's annoying. Super annoying. I guess we're running the rest of the way. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. You know what? No. I'm gonna find me a cliff. I'm not running the whole way to the coal mine.
Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive.
Well, I could have changed to that little one.
The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying
to
destroy me.
Didn't have to die after all.
It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
Gotta check in the dingy cabins.
This is Pat Main, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big shot G-Man with an itchy trigger finger who could use a lesson in manners and a boot in the ass. Not necessarily in that order either. That our Sheriff Breaker was there to straighten things out.
Whoa, ghost barrels. Going to the mine to get my wife back, cause she's an expensive robot. I mean, she's a real life human that I love. Do 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 do. How many cars am I gonna steal on this mountain? It's the car from the dream. I'm gonna hit a hitchhiker. Oh, there's a whole nother building over there. Bound to have secrets in it. Red bush. Probably nothing. Oh, that's a big old cliff right there. But why does it look like the train has an interior? Alright, let's get back in the car. We've got hitchhikers to run over. Kids and shit. It's the shitmobile.
I was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now.
While lucrative at first, the mining steadily declined in the 20th century. The seams were rich, but hard to get at, and the volcanic activity in the area made the mine shafts particularly dangerous. Ah, so this is what all their mother truckers have been hitting me with, all their mining equipment. No, don't drive. Get that coffee. Nothing. Unless maybe it's something. Toilets. In 1970, a volcanic eruption below Cauldron Lake, while relatively minor, caused most of the deep mining tunnels to collapse or flood. 32 miners lost their lives in the calamity, and all mining around Bright Falls came to a final stop. Now many of the remaining buildings are protected as historical landmarks. Because history is nothing if a map of our...
I didn't want to go outside.
Continued environmental disasters.
The cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
It's you. You are the kidnapper, Mr. Darkness. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Wake!
Where the hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello? Ah!
I'm gonna kill him.
I had to get to Mirror Peak. It was close. Maybe closer than ever before.
Nothing down this end. Nobody, nope, nope, nope. Super fun, happy slide. Come on, let me dodge, you son of a bitch. What's up, big fella? Good. Everyone okay? Good. Hell yeah, flashbangs. Anything back here? You got my coffee? For a subconscious, demon. Not super great with the old aim. Anything in here? Are you gonna let me up? I have to walk up the ramp.
What the hell?
Fear tornado. Yay. It's a tornado of fear.
The only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
I mean, don't go through the building. Easy. Spin, drop, roll, no. Power's all the way over there. Then we gotta fight our way back over here, I guess. Still just running around factories, murdering the workers. Because who wouldn't do that? Ass. Bullshit. Anything else around here? No, not really. Anyone in here? Hello?
Come on, back it up. Funky-ass monkeys. Y'all still downstairs? Nah. Creepy chair. Oh, what? I'm back in the same building I started in? Oh no, just a similar building. Trust no one in the dark. I mean, I don't know specifically why you can. I get that they're all darkness monsters, but personally, trust no one ever, regardless of illumination. But that's just because I am odd. Follow the yellow brick road. What are we following? Come on, open. Use. There's a bit of blackout. Well, the gate's open at least. That's enough.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
Just cleaning up the goop. Man, I've really got to go to the toilet. Oh, there's a shadow man. I'll see you. Alright, I'll be back. Alrighty, we are back. Shadow people are coming, as they tend to do. Come on then. What are y'all gonna do? Freaking assholes. Back on the happy trail.
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Hell yeah. Pump shoddy. About it. Which way do we go? Wasn't really anything up here, was there? Just more folks trying to kill me. Come on then. Come on, you sacks of... sacks of sassafras. Where'd I pick up the pump action?
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
Yeah. I reached.
The dark presence was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
The graveyard shift may cause cancer.
Not so good at climbing, are you, Blinky? Just emptying.
The place was dead. A ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
Delicious. I wonder what's going to come out here. Bullshit. There's literally nothing you can do against the inanimate objects. Pick up a key.
outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Zane believes it's a mirror to the gaping void of darkness above, where some Lovecraftian presence lurks. I crawl back upstairs. I'll borrow these things for my story. They ring true. They fit.
What's better, shotgun or pump? Whoa. I mean, I've got 8 shots in the pump action. What, 5 in the rifle? Yeah. Jelly-legged freak. Faster, faster. Come on, champ. Pick up the pace.
The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up.
Birds. I freaking hate birds. Oh shit. Less than I hate falling off the cliffs.
Birds.
Just fell to the ground. He's just running around in an abandoned mine shaft. That's a good idea. That's what a not insane person would do for sure. What's up, Alice? I know you think I'm insane, but that's just because I am. It's really nothing to worry about. Thanks, helpful. It's super bright in here for not having any light sources. Nothing up here. Let's go down some more.
To make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Seems like a very strange way to position a elevator. Like surely just having one control and then, you know, being normal about it. Ow! God damn it. Alright. So I've got to knock that ladder down. So then I can reset this once the ladder's down and I can climb up there regularly. Leap! Oh no! Damn it, piss!
I'd have to make my way up this mine shaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
Look, just because you made yourself a robot wife doesn't mean the machines are your friend. Alright? Anyway, you killed your robot wife. The machines would hate you. Oh, the fucking wires. God damn you. Cool ass way to make a clipping point. Yeah, I know. Up the mine shaft. Let's go. Come on, champ. Maybe if you weren't such an insane dipshit, your wife wouldn't have to put you through all this just to get you to write a story. Do you ever think about that? No, you didn't. Because you never think about anything but yourself, do you, Alan? now it breaks. Creepy creaking noises. Still gotta get to the lookout. But which way am I supposed to go? Oh shit. Probably not this way. Well, we're down here now. Gaspar, kicking in. Chest on fire. Wife, a robot. I'm no award-winning novelist or anything, but I'm pretty sure there are easier ways to get a book out than to murder an entire town's worth of logging workers, or miners, as the case may be. Crappy old generator, what are you gonna do, 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 do? Shut down in the middle of the freaking span. Then I find out I can control the darkness after all. Yep. Punks, think you can mess with me? Don't you know I'm a writer?
Shit.
Okay. That was a little intense, sure. But who hasn't had a train thrown at them? Where did the train come from? I wonder. Running through the forest to get my robot wife. I mean, she's not a robot, but she is my wife. She's a human woman. Doesn't point the gun where he's looking. Let's just get up here. What's that? You're not gonna do nothing now? Little shadow bitches. Rickety rope bridge, rickety rope bridge, running along a rickety rope bridge. Oh, don't be a puss. Just a bunch of crunch of flares. At the manuscript page. There's like, I think 15 in this episode, manuscript pages, and I've got maybe 6 of them. It's a big old block. A writer's block, some might say. humor. Kick it. Ah, you pushed it this time. Do the old kick push. Glide. Excuse me, I would like to get inside your building. CH and TZ. Okay. You talk to me on TV, Tom. I know that homeboy just happens to have the same name as me, but seeing my name in a game is super creepy. I curse you, Thomas Zane. Yeah, my last name's not Zane. It is Mod Populous. Can't open it. Well, this is a creepy little room. Don't need any more revolver ammo. I'm no longer carrying the shotgun, so that's a good time to pick up shotgun ammo. Super cool. I'm surprised there's no manuscript page in the crazy person room. The old invisible ink, aka pissing on the walls. What's up, everybody? You really want to fuck with me? Shadows. You merely adopted the darkness.
I was shaped by it, molded by it.
Hey, it was I was born in it, molded by it.
Could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find.
Wait! Are you? Wait!
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
She is! She
You are the most passing out protagonist. Every chapter ends with you having a little nap. Why? Just finish your story, bro. Dun dun dun. Dun 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 dun. And then we go into copyrighted music, so I have to just talk over all of this. But that was chapter 3, episode 3, and that is the end of episode 3. So, I will see you next time. Yeah, as always, 2 hours, goddamn, that was a long freaking episode. As always, stay safe, stay happy, do all the good things, and I'll see you in the future. Bye-bye for now.